Вообще очень. Еще все пиздатый прям. I started graffiti when I was 10 years old, as I saw my best friend painting on the street, and that interested me a lot. Then I bought my first marker, and it all started. I do graffiti because I like it. It's part of my life, as I want to do it by myself. Thanks to graffiti, I met my loved one, and I thank graffiti for that. My favorite tool for graffiti is shoot brush. I adore it. I also use acid tools like acid, character pen, and human paint. Actually stopped buying markers and inks because my friend has said that his own inks and they're perfect for this morning. The graffiti scene in Russia is behind other graffiti scenes. The ropes and bomb ink is not yet fully developed. Most try to make a complicated piece. We have similar stereotype rules, like if you make a colorful piece, it is okay to color through. So everyone tries to get followers on its style, not even trying to understand the culture. Everyone sees themselves as composers, but they don't have any tags in the street. The main thing to me is to be an individual and do more than the other bombers do. I don't like being compared to others grouped together with others. If someone got more tents in the street than me, it becomes a motivated competition for me until I'm up more. It's important for me to see my tents when I'm walking around the city. It makes me cool. I got arrested the first time when I was 15, and the day after I volunteered in police car. The day after, the time I ran away from police station and made it impossible for my parents to pick me up. So yeah, I've been caught several times. In Russia, it's not a big deal, it's like being caught for drinking alcohol. Eventually, I become better and understanding not how to get caught. Besides graffiti, it's important to me to be successful in other spheres where you actually make money. Money is a very important tool in your personal development. A lot of possibilities open with money. Thank you. People don't appreciate the most valuable resource you have, time. You won't ever get it back. The political situation in the country makes people fight each other. Whenever I went to war and died there, I just couldn't truly agree on side. It's impossible. People are dying, borders are closing, stores are closing, and prices are rising, and tons of other bullshit things affect everyone. Of course, I'm against as well. It's completely absurd to me, especially that it's happening in the modern world. Unfortunately, war is inevitable, whether you like it or not. The war is a global conflict and is orchestrated by people higher up in the hierarchy, and at the same time, ordinary people fight in the streets, fight online, and spread a lot of hate.